The US Air Force has successfully completed a series of tests of a new 5,000-pound class bunker buster bomb, the GBU-72B. This included the release of a prototype weapon from an F-15E Strike Eagle combat jet over a range associated with Eglin Air Force Base in Florida. While the bomb has been tested earlier this year, US Air Force has announced this development only now. The weapon is developed under a program sometimes referred to as the Advanced 5,000-Pound Warhead, or Advanced 5,000-Pound Penetrator, and abbreviated A5K. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Advanced 5,000-Pound Penetrator will be a splendid addition for the US Air Force. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. As per the US Air Force, while cruising over the Eglin Air Force Base range, a 96th Test Wing F-15E Strike Eagle released a GBU-72 Advanced 5K Penetrator at 35,000 feet October 7th. The 5,000-pound bomb's release marked the end of a test series planned by the 780th Test Squadron and performed by the 40th Flight Test Squadron. According to the release, the squadron's test goals were to show the weapon could safely release from the aircraft and validate a modified 2,000-pound Joint Direct Attack Munition tail kit's ability to control and navigate a 5,000-pound weapon. It was added that the test series, deemed a success by the Armament Directorate's Direct Attack Division, consisted of 3 flights, and those flights and drops were made much more complex since the first GBU-72 release. Ronald Forch, 780th TS Programming Engineer over the GBU-72 flight and ground test efforts, said, "Test series of this magnitude are never successful overall because of just a single person or organization. They're ultimately successful because the test engineer is able to perform a role very similar to that of a symphony conductor guiding the performance of a series of consecutive miracles, none any more important than the other." From the outside, GBU-72B looks like an enlarged 2,000-pound class GBU-31B Joint Direct Attack Munition, JDAM, precision-guided bomb configured with a bunker buster warhead like BLU-109B or BLU-137B. As per the US Air Force, the GBU-72 was developed to overcome hardened, deeply buried target challenges and designed for both fighter and bomber aircraft. The weapon design and its projected effectiveness were developed using advanced modeling and simulation techniques and processes before the first warhead was forged. This is a repeatable process for all future direct attack weapons. Lethality is expected to be substantially higher compared to similar legacy weapons like the GBU-28, according to James Culleton, GBU-72 program manager. Culleton said, "An advantage to the modeling and simulation to design approach used is that early prototypes are production representative. This helps us bring our operational test partners in sooner with eyes-on, hands-on participation. Validating our design and procedures sooner while including input that improves the weapon. The collaboration we've enjoyed with the 780th TS and 40th FLTS, to this end, has been the best I've experienced in acquisitions. It was added that the GBU 72 program now moves on to additional JDAM integration test flights and developmental and operational testing in 2022. As such, the GBU 72B looks set to provide an improved bunker busting capability for use against targets that are out of reach of GBU 31B series bombs, but it's not fit for a GBU 57AB Massive Ordnance Penetrator, or MOP, which is a precision guided 30,000 pound or 14,000 kilogram bomb. Also, the GBU 72B's use of the JDAM, GPS, and INS guidance package, rather than GBU 28B's laser guidance, gives the US Air Force the ability to conduct strikes in any weather condition. The GBU 72 Advanced 5K Penetrator is designed to punch through deeply buried bunkers and other reinforced structures and then explode. The high accuracy will ensure that the weapon will act as a precision strike option. While the exact penetration capability is not disclosed, it's likely to be between GBU 31B series bombs and Massive Ordnance Penetrator. Several countries are using bunkers to safeguard their weapons. Even second-tier powers like Iran and North Korea are using this tactic. Iran has several kinds of cruise missiles, as well as short and intermediate-range ballistic missiles. These are deployed on highly reinforced mountain fortresses, which will be very difficult to destroy, especially if using conventional options. The same is the situation with North Korea. North Korea's Coxin artillery piece has a range of about 25 miles or 40 kilometers using conventional projectiles. However, with a rocket-assisted shell, it can strike at a distance of around 40 miles or 60 kilometers and is a major problem for South Korea. Placed into hard granite mountain faces and protected behind blast doors, these coxins will be hard to detect as well as very complicated to neutralize. GBU 72B will be useful in these situations. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.